Our second chapter, solutions. The first word of solutions we have studied in the first years in some basic concepts. Concentration of solutions. So I think there is no need to discuss it in detail. We can see some problems related to it. Solutions are classified into different types based on the nature of solute and solvent. Solutions contain a solute and a solvent, or solutes and a solvent. There will be one solvent and one solute, or many solutes. If there is only one solvent and one solute, we can call it as a binary solution. These binary solutions can be classified into 9 types as explained here. Gaseous solution, 3 types of gaseous solutions are present. Gas dissolved in gas. We know air is an example. Oxygen and nitrogen. Oxygen dissolved in nitrogen. Liquid dissolved in gas. Liquid vapors, when it is mixed with the gases, we get such a solution. Liquid dissolved in gas. Chloroform mixed with the nitrogen gas. Solid dissolved in gas. We know there are volatile solids. For example, camphor. Camphor, when it evaporates, it will form a solution with the air or nitrogen. That is an example for solid in gas type solution. Our liquid solutions, 3 types of liquid solutions. Gas dissolved in liquid, oxygen dissolved in water, carbon dioxide dissolved in water, soda water is an example. Liquid dissolved in liquid. Ethanol dissolves in water. Ethanol water solution is an example. Kerosene and petrol. When you mix these two, that will dissolve each other and forms a solution. Solid dissolved in liquid is a common type of solution. Glucose dissolved in water, or salt dissolved in water. Solid dissolved in liquid. Glucose solution, salt solution, common type of solution. Now solid solutions. Gas dissolved in solid. Hydrogen electrode is an example. Hydrogen gas when bubbled through palladium or platinum, hydrogen gas dissolves in palladium to form a solution. Liquid dissolved in solid. Amalgam of mercury with the sodium. Sodium amalgam, we'll call it as sodium amalgam, zinc amalgam. These amalgams are examples or solution of liquid dissolved in solid. Solid dissolved in solid. Alloys are examples. Copper dissolved in gold. Now you have to recollect the various methods for the calculation of concentrations. Concentrations of solutions. The first one, mass fraction. What is mass fraction? Mass of one component divided by total mass of solution. Now, mass percentage. Mass fraction into 100. That is mass percentage. It's only to recollect. Last year you have studied it in detail. Parts per million, ppm, that is equal to mass fraction into 10^6. Now mole fraction, represented as X, actually it is chi, equal to number of moles of one component divided by total number of moles. Next, molality of a solution, represented as mole letter M, is equal to WB into 1000 divided by MB into WA. WB by MB is number of moles of solute. WA, mass of solvent. So what is molality? Is number of moles of solute present per kilogram of solvent. Molarity, capital M, represented with the capital M, equal to WB into 1000 divided by MB into V. WB by MB, number of moles of solute. V, volume of solution. So molarity, number of moles of solute present per liter of solution. Normality, you may remember normality, represented as N. N is equal to WB into 1000 divided by EB into V. Here WB divided by EB, number of equivalents. EB is equivalent mass. WB by EB, number of equivalents. V, volume. So normality, number of moles of solute present per liter of solution. Here in the equation, you can see in molarity and normality, volume is present in the equation. Volume, the term volume is present. So with the change in temperature, you can expect a small change in the values of molarity and normality. But molality and mole fraction or mass fraction, that will not change with the temperature, because temperature has no effect on mass. Next, some problems to recollect. What is the first question? Calculate the mass percentage of benzene and carbon tetrachloride if 22 gram of benzene is dissolved in 122 gram of carbon tetrachloride. You may remember the equation, mass fraction is equal to mass of component divided by total mass. Here component is benzene, mass of component is 22 divided by total mass. Mass of carbon tetrachloride plus benzene, 122 plus 22 equal to 144. So 22 divided by 144. Second question, calculate the mole fraction of benzene in solution containing 30% by mass in carbon tetrachloride. So 30% by mass, what is its meaning? 30% by mass means 30 gram benzene present in 100 gram solution. 30 gram benzene present in 100 gram solution. So mass of benzene 30 gram, mass of carbon tetrachloride 100 minus 70. That is equal to, 100 minus 30 equal to 70. And here number of moles of benzene W by M equal to 30 by 78 is equal to 0.385. Number of moles of carbon tetrachloride is equal to 70 by 154. 154 is the molecular mass of carbon tetrachloride, equal to 0.455. Mole fraction of benzene, number of moles of benzene divided by total number of moles. That is 0.385 divided by 0.385 plus 0.455 equal to 0.458. Now number of mole fraction of CCl4. Sum of mole fractions of all the components in a solution is equal to 1. You know it. Here it is a binary solution, contains only 2 components. Therefore, mole fraction of carbon tetrachloride plus mole fraction of benzene is equal to 1, or mole fraction of carbon tetrachloride is equal to 1 minus 0.458 is equal to 0.542. I think it is clear to you. Again, see the question. Calculate the molarity of each of the following solutions. A 30 gram of cobalt nitrate hydrated form, CONO3 twice 6H2O. in 4.3 liters of solution. It is a simple problem. Molarity is equal to WB by MB into 1000 by V. WB, is it given? Yes, 30 gram. MB, molecular mass of CO and NO3 twice 6H2O. CO atomic mass 58.7. Nitrogen, you know, 14 grams. Oxygen, 16 grams. H2O, 18 grams. So by, you can calculate the molecular mass. So WB by MB, mass by molecular mass, into 1000, divided by volume. Volume is clearly given, 4.3 liters. If it is given in liters, then there is no need to write 1000. Otherwise, what you have to write? 4,300 ml. Substitute and find out the answer. B, 30 ml of 0.5 molar H2O, so for diluted to 500 ml. Last year we have studied an equation, you may remember. V1 M1 is equal to V2 M2 for dilution. So here V1 30 ml into M1 0.5 equal to V2 500 ml into M2. Therefore you can find out M2. M2 is equal to 30 into 0.5 divided by 500. You can calculate it. Next, calculate mass of urea, NH2, CO, NH2, required in making 2.5 kilogram of 0.25 molal aqueous solution. So molality, molal means molality. Molality 0.25. The mass of solution 2.5 kilogram. Molecular mass of urea, you can calculate it and you will get it as 60 gram. So here, what is unknown here? We can see 0.25 molal, molality is given. What is meant by molality? Number of moles of solute present per kilogram of solvent. Number of moles of solute present per kilogram of solvent. So 0.25 mol is present in 1 kilogram of solvent. 1 kilogram of solvent. So we can take it as to find out the mass of urea that is used for making this solution. 0.25 is equal to WB divided by 60 into 1000 divided by 1000. 1 kilogram means 1000. Then you will get mass of urea, mass of urea for mass of urea required for making 1 kilogram, making the solution of this concentration, 0.25 molar concentration, molal concentration. After getting the mass of urea, we can find out the total mass of solution by adding 1 kilogram plus mass of urea in kilogram. That will be the total mass. From that, you can find out mass of urea required for 2.5 kilogram of 0.25 molar solution. Is it clear? First, M, you have to use the equation, small letter M is equal to WB by MB into 1000 by WA. Here, molality 0.25, that is equal to WB, that we have to find out, divided by 60 into 1000 divided by 1000. 1 kilogram means 1000. Thus, you will get mass of urea required for the preparation of 0.25 molar aqueous solution. Then total mass of solution 1 plus mass of urea. From this you can find out mass of urea required for 2.5 kilogram of 0.25 molar aqueous solution. Next question, calculate molality, molarity and mole fraction of potassium iodide if the density of 20% aqueous potassium iodide is 1.202 gram per mole. Molality we can calculate easily. Molality is equal to WB by MB into 1000 by WA. You take 20 gram as the mass of potassium iodide. Then what will be the mass of water? 100 minus 20 equal to 80. Then if you know the molecular mass of potassium iodide, you can calculate molality. Molality is equal to WB into 1000 divided by MB into WA. WB is 20. We took it as 20 into 1000 divided by molecular mass of potassium iodide 166 into 80. 80 is the mass of water equal to 1.5 is the answer. Molality. If you want to find out molarity, what is the equation? Molarity WB into 1000 divided by MV into V. We have to find out volume of solution. How will you find out volume of solution? From mass of solution, we can find out volume of solution. Mass of solution is 100 gram. Since the percentage is given, we can take the mass of solution as 100 gram. Volume is equal to mass divided by density. Density is given 1.202. So 100 by 1.202 is equal to 83.2 ml. Now we can substitute it in the equation. WB into 1000 divided by MB into V. 20 into 1000 divided by 166 into 83.2. So answer is 1.44. If you want to find out the mole fraction, you need number of moles of solute and number of moles of solvent. Number of moles of solute, you know, 20 divided by 166 potassium iodide. Number of moles of solute, solvent, 80 gram water divided by 18. Number of moles of potassium iodide, you can see 20 divided by 0.12. Number of moles of H2O, 80 divided by 84.44, and X is equal to number of moles of potassium iodide divided by total number of moles of solution. That is 0.12 divided by 0.12 plus 4.44. That is 4.56 equal to 0.263. You can solve a number of problems, and these problems are a very important calculation of concentrations. Last year we solved many problems, so you refer that notebook and textbook. Now the solubility. Next one is solubility. What is meant by solubility? We can see the first is solubility of a solid in liquid. Solubility of a substance is its maximum amount that can be dissolved in a specified amount of solvent at a specific temperature. If you fix the temperature and fix the volume, that solvent can dissolve a particular amount of the substance. That amount is known as the solubility of a substance. This is the maximum amount. That is very important. Maximum amount that can be dissolved. So solubility depends on the nature of the solute and solvent, temperature and pressure. You know, certain, for example, sodium chloride, that is readily soluble in water. Readily soluble in water. You know, sodium chloride is an ionic salt. But if you take calcium sulfate, that is not so readily soluble in water. So solubility depends on nature of solute and solvent. Now solubility of a solution in a liquid. For example, when we discussed the liquid solutions, we told alcohol dissolves in water, ethanol dissolves in water. What is the reason? Ethanol is polar, water also polar. So a polar solvent can dissolve a polar solute. A non-polar solvent can dissolve a non-polar solute. So we can say like dissolves like. A solution in which no more solute can be dissolved at the same temperature and pressure is called a saturated solution. Saturated solution is the solution in which maximum amount of solute is dissolved. Further dissolution is not possible. Maximum amount is dissolved. That is a saturated solution. An unsaturated solution is one in which more solute can be dissolved. A few more amount of solute can be dissolved. That is an unsaturated. So saturated solution, unsaturated, maximum amount is dissolved. Further dissolution is not possible. Unsaturated, we can have more amount of solution. Sorry, solute to the solvent. It will dissolve. The concentration of solute in a saturated solution is its solubility. Actually, what is solubility? It is the concentration of solute in a saturated solution. If the dissolution process is endothermic, the solubility should increase with the rise in temperature. What is meant by endothermic? It will absorb temperature during dissolution. If it is an endothermic reaction, the solubility increases with increase in temperature. And if it is exothermic, the solubility decreases with the increase in temperature. And the pressure has no effect on solubility. Okay, for today, I think it is enough. And I will give you an assignment. You have to answer the questions and submit it in the due time. Okay, thank you.